15 minutes. Just letting you know.
Oh man, I know that feeling. of a whole row of your guys' trucks, and they were all 352s. You know, so those are like out of the 70s.
I was running back around the 60s, late 60s. Because they talked about used to haul the old Euclids out of Ohio there.
28-ton limit bridge. Brilliant!
Yep. Ain't nothing surprised me.
Well, it's not like ever in the history of ever has a permit put a truck driver to where he'll hit shit and knock a bridge down up in northern Washington by running his permitted route.
Yeah.
dream on the table. I said, well, a dream, but I still got it on a table. Just not quite ready to pull the trigger on that thing yet, because that's going to be a full-on build, the one I'm eyeballing.
Yeah, I know. An old 63 Mac, I had to fire the four for the self-mount number 9, and a couple of straight trucks had. One had a 5 and a 4, and the other one had a 5 and a 3.
Do you guys even have owner-operators still, or I don't think I ever see them?
Oh, we got two of them.
Who?
There's John there, he's got a... It's a champagne-colored Peterbilt with red fenders. And we got another guy with a Freightliner there. It's a, like a deep purple dude. He lives out there in Illinois. John lives down there in Carlisle.
All of them trucks you guys got, you got two owner-operators. Basically, that's none.
Yeah, John's been here since they started the company there. He's worked in the office, dispatching, he's done a little bit of everything.
Oh, okay, that's probably why then. All right. I was just saying, I didn't know you guys didn't really have owner-operators. I thought you said that, and I'm like, wait a minute, what?
Yeah, Sam's the other one there. He's been here since 96.
I know some carriers, they don't like dealing with them, you know, like when I was with Trail Cam, you know, everything was cool, but one day you could tell, it wasn't like something that was ever told to us drivers, but one day you could tell they wanted rid of us owner operators, and they weren't just going to tell you to pack sand and leave, they would make you leave, and they squeezed us out.
Yeah, there used to be a bunch more than 2008, canceled everybody's leases, all except for John.
Yeah, old Johnny Krill Cam, he just starved us out. That was his answer to making us go. And one by one we dropped. Literally within like a year, it went real bad. The problem was, like when I came over here to Whitmire's, John lost so many guys so fast he didn't plan on that. And most of us jumped ship and came to Whitmire. He didn't plan on that. So he was kind of like begging guys to stay. It was kind of weird, like he didn't want us. And then when we all left all at the same time, then he was begging us to stay. And I'm like, well, you should have thought about that.
Almost 300. think I at least have four trucks, and I don't find them for quality drivers nowadays.
up to me. It's a great run. I wish you good chat and wait you too.
Well, it's good talk to you. I'll drop the tape.
Oh, yeah.